event news. We've got the SAG-AFTRA thing. We'll get to that in just a second. San Diego Comic-Con, of course, going to be impacted by that quite a bit. But we do have some things that are actually going to be going on at San Diego Comic-Con. And we've got some of those announcements this week. EigoManga, that publish digital comics and animations and games, they will be showcasing their wares. And they will have manga artist Chang Sheng at their booth signing. He is the award-winning creator of Old Man. He'll make an in-person appearance to meet fans and sign autographs. He'll be taking part in a panel discussion called Writing for Comics and Manga. So there is that to look forward to. Also at San Diego Comic-Con, this new addition to the Jurassic Park Hammond collection, a 3¾-inch Steven Spielberg action figure, comes with a director's chair and movie camera, animatronic Dilophosaurus. This is the spitter. It has the removable frills. It's Comic-Con exclusive. The package can be used as a clapboard. The actual box it comes in can be used as a clapboard. This figure will be available at the Mattel booth and online at Mattel Creations starting July 21st. There are a limit. Two figures per buyer is the limit on that. And we've also got plans for Warner Brothers Discovery Home Entertainment bringing four original animated movies to the screen there during panel presentations, likely without actors now. Venture Brothers, Radiant is the Blood of the Baboon Heart, will have its world premiere. We'll also have the Metalocalypse Army of the Doomstar, and will be featuring clips there. Justice League War World will also premiere, as will Babylon 5, The Road Home. So all of those will get their screenings at San Diego Comic-Con. Now, with regard to the SAG-AFTRA thing, the Actors Union is on strike. There's a lot of confusion. There's a lot of back and forth and discussion about what's going to happen, who can do what, when can they do it. As I understand it, as far as we're able to clarify from various different posts online and different things, from different conventions have posted things, actors have posted things. As I understand it, the actors are still able to attend conventions. And somebody asked about doing podcasts in the chat. As far as I know, they can, as long as they are not promoting any work done by a studio against which they're striking. So they can come in and they can talk about their acting process. They can talk about, you know, what they had for breakfast. They can sign autographs and they can say how neat it is to be an actor. But they can't actually talk about any particular project that they are currently involved in, whether it's something that's been shot and is out there or it's in production. So with those limitations, actors are still able to make appearances at conventions. Now, there might be some other restrictions, and that thing might get a little wibbly-wobbly as SAG-AFTRA continues to clarify those restrictions. But that's my understanding as it is now, what's going on for any of that. So, now, some actors may just decide that they're not going to do any appearances at all in regard to this strike. But we don't know that for sure. All right, we do have a couple of things. One of the things we're going to be looking at is, you know, with our school closings list, we'll probably be looking at whether or not the strike starts to affect those things. We know that productions are being shut down. Everything's pretty much come to a standstill here in the United States. There's still some stuff shooting overseas. There's stuff shooting in Australia. But we will continue to keep track of that, and we might end up doing an entry, some sort of a category on our school closings list with regard to that. Now, we do have here, continuing to update our master list of conventions. We're over 2,500. Mrs. Boss is doing that. We have added smaller events. Author appearances, Q&As, and signings, and all of that, in-person readings. We're going to try to expand on that as well. So if you've got an event you want to make sure is on our list, send us an email, events@scififorme.com. like I said, we're over 2,500 on that list over there at the main site. And one of the things that we do that nobody else does, we help you plan your travel because we have the weather forecast for the cities that are hosting conventions. So here is that for next weekend.
Multiverse, Saturday morning at 11, 10 Central, only on Sci-Fi for Me TV.